I welcome you, precious people, to Word of the Week. Today we are looking at knowing the peaceful presence. Peace is a big question in life. How do I have peace? How do I live in peace perpetually? How do I lead others into a peaceful, restful life? Unfortunately, peace cannot be bought, nor does it come through accomplishments, productivity, or human creation. One person has little troubles, yet knows no peace at all. Another has many troubles, and yet have abundant peace. What does this tell us? Peace is a secret to be discovered by human soul. It has a path. Walk that path, and you find peace in your soul in great measures. Fish lives in waters and can only prosper in water. To fish, water is their peaceful natural habitat. Birds only navigate in open sky. They are creatures for height. Put a bird in the sky and you put her in her natural habitat, where her embedded life finds expression. All creatures have a natural habitat. Fish has, birds have, the human body also has, which is the physical world. Our souls are different. The natural world is not habitat to our souls. Our souls are spiritual, moral, emotional, and intellectual creations. As birds soar in open skies, so our souls too soar as it interacts with elements outside the physical world. Your soul is in touch with a world not visible to the physical human eyes. The things that make the soul to react often are not physical things. Things like perception of hope, sense of love, belief system, perseverance, self-control, etc. are elements that rule the soul. Yet these things are not material substance. Things like sorrow, sense of loss and evil, impatience, anger, hidden inner fears, lust, greed, etc. things that plunder and spoil the soul are also not material substance, but things that really exist and determine the state of our souls. It is like this: when you are thirsty, no matter the amount of soft or hard drinks you take, your thirst will never be quenched. Water alone quenches human thirst completely and satisfactorily. In other words, the human thirst is satisfied by the cheapest possible means, water, in natural creation. There's a message here. Only things money cannot buy satisfies. Only things man cannot create satisfies. Soft and hard drinks are man-made and expensive, yet does not satisfy human thirst in the least. In fact, they lead to more thirst. The message here is clear. Only what God naturally made satisfies, and they are the cheapest in the world today. That means the things that satisfies us are cheap. If we don't get this point clear and early enough, we will misunderstand considerably the whole essence of life. Only natural life satisfies. Thank God for your cash. You can get many things, but satisfaction comes from natural life. All that we need to live satisfied are abundantly supplied by God. Anything human hands touches becomes expensive and also less satisfying. Water is cheaper than other forms of drinks. Fruits are cheaper than processed food. Natural transportation system is free. Your legs. You can walk anywhere freely. Sure, you will prefer to have your legs to have in a private car without legs. Private car is a good plus to life. But we are simply saying your legs are superior and more satisfying to have. We can do without cars, but not without our legs. Both are transport systems. Your legs are free, cars are super expensive. God offers things free. Man offers it at a big price. God offers superior things free, man offers inferior things super expensive. All man-made inventions are inferior to God-made things. These analyses are even for the things that pertain to our physical material world. They are also true for our souls. The things that makes for joy, peace, and satisfaction are different from the thoughts of many people. They think that, like humans, peace will be costly because man's provisions are costly, but then God's provisions are free. The thing that floods the human soul with peace are not man's made, but God's made. Things like love, patience, perseverance, hope, faith, gentleness, goodness, self-control, etc. are the natural habitat for peace to the human soul. Many are looking for peace from man-made things. What an error. The wrong way will lead to wrong destination. Fish lives in water. Birds navigate the open skies. The human soul lives in God and navigates the attributes of God to experience renewal, strengthening, and grace. The attributes of God in us blesses others, but first and foremost, possessing them is for our own good. A patient, good, kind, loving, and forgiving person will always have more peace than the unforgiving person. The unforgiving person will always be bitter and broken. An impatient person will always be on the edge and sister brother to anger and impromptu mistake. To know the peaceful present is a deliberate thing. Grow, cultivate, and nurture peaceful virtues within. It's beyond prayer point and Bible studies, though those are pivotal beginning steps to take towards it. You must build upon prayers by deliberately growing, nurturing, and cultivating fruits within that changes your personality within for the better. Sometimes, or rather many times, it's not our situation that needs to change, but our perspective and thought patterns towards things before us. We cannot stop the rainfalls, but we can build roofs over our heads. We may not be able to stop people insulting us, but we can decide to walk past insults and move on. Knowing the peaceful present within is not wishy-washy, but a call to cultivate peace within by nurturing the environment of peace within us as we grow and strengthen things that make for peace in our souls. Abound in patience, abound in more peace. Abound in everlasting hope, and abound in unbroken peace. Abound in grace and understanding towards people, and abound in more peace. Abound in love and tolerance, and know more and more peace. The world will never give you peace, nor even give you the opportunity to have peace. In the world, you shall have tribulation. Peace is your sole responsibility to implant in yourself with the help of the Lord. The hope set before us is our everlasting peace. Know it and abound in it. The hope set before us is another world coming outside of this sinking world. The good Lord grant us peace in greater measures daily in Jesus' name, as He helps us to do all we could to grow the peaceful presence within. Amen. Thank you. God bless you. Amen.